We will not be starting out bashing Tom. We'll start out bashing Ken. So, hey, it's, are we?
Oh, hi.
Yeah. Is it only YouTube or are we out on multiple platforms this morning?
Only YouTube.
Only on YouTube today. Good morning, YouTube. I am Kevin Michalowski here with attorney Tom Grieve and great, wonderful, huge attorney, big law firm, all of those sorts of things. And this is basically, am I correct, Max, in ask me anything sort of back and forth operation. So we want to get out here and share some of our valuable insights and information. So people don't pay us for our good looks. It's right, definitely not.
I deliberately ask them to unfocus the camera, actually.
Yeah.
So,
they ask if they could back up a little
bit.
And he's like going to the Twin Cities.
I need that wide photo.
Yeah, I need that. We will make that work. So what's new in your world, Tom? What can we chat about today?
We've got the expo coming up. That's about 10 days out at this point, a little over a week.
I'm getting
ready to put together. I've got some presentations that I'm looking forward to. I gave a couple last year. We're going to be focusing and kind of retooling some this year. We've got some exciting content coming out. We've got a lot of attorneys and guest speakers coming. We're going to be serving on the legal Q&A panel. I'm looking forward Friday night to doing the live training broadcast, live LTB. It's going to be like a college game day experience.
Yeah, we're doing we have the live Proving Ground, live scenario-based training, which will happen right there in front of the Friday night viewers and guests. But this is, hard to believe now, the fifth Concealed Carry Expo, the fifth annual Concealed Carry Expo. And like you said, this is an educational event as well as a consumer show. We will have lots of cool and interesting stuff going on. And I think the legal aspect of it, there are probably some people out there who understand the insights of what's happening in Pittsburgh, Pittsburgh in particular, and across Pennsylvania in general. So putting together this this expo has been a challenge, making sure that we're getting everybody there. And not only, when I say everybody there, getting the vendors there, getting everything set up and working the way that we want it to work. But it is coming together. It's coming together very well. And there's going to be some really cool stuff going on.
And it's really the perfect place, I think, as a result, to host something like this.
Yeah.
I mean, it's right on the front lines. If you want to see what happens if you don't have a strong, vibrant, pro-Second Amendment community, I'm not saying they don't have that in Pittsburgh. We look forward to seeing that in Pittsburgh. Yeah. And really, it's thanks to that community in Pittsburgh that they've been holding the line over there as best that they have.
Yeah.
So,
and this is a place where we need to have that discussion of who we are and what we do, because there's been some pushback to our presence in Pittsburgh by the Pittsburgh city government based on the Squirrel Hill synagogue shooting. And quite honestly, we believe that with our training and education and people who are actively responding to situations like this, that would have reduced the death toll or maybe even stopped it altogether. And what we're trying to do is at least have that discussion and have a reasonable, rational debate. Some folks on the other side are not quite so reasonable and rational, but the expo is going to be a perfect place to have that debate and to let the two sides come together. We welcome anybody in the Pittsburgh area. Come on in and see what we do. As long as you are a decent, kind, reasonable, rational human being, show up at the Concealed Carry Expo in Pittsburgh starting on the 17th of May and just take a look around and learn what the concealed carry lifestyle is all about. We have classes. Many of them are free. I think most of the paid ones are already filled up now at this point. But we'll have demonstrations going on the demonstration stage. We will have all sorts of things that you can shop for and all sorts of experts, including Tom and a lot of his legal buddies out there talking about the importance of what we do and how we do it and being safe and responsibly armed Americans.
And I think Kevin just really hit it right there. You know, for people who are already in this community, who are already in this lifestyle, this is the perfect spot. This is the perfect time and place to take wherever you're at and to try to get to wherever you're going, to take the next couple steps on that journey. Maybe it's a question about gear, about law, about defensive techniques, whatever it might be. For those of you who are not in it, but are curious about it, or thinking about carrying, or do have a license and firearm, but you need to really get into the habit of carrying every day, this is the perfect spot to go in, ask questions, learn from people who have been there and done that, and really mingle and network and meet all sorts of other folks to see what it's really like. Where does this look like? What does this place look like? And just get out there.
Yeah, and one of the most popular areas of the expo is the women's showroom. We started this a couple of years ago, and it is a women's only area in the expo where women can go and get advice and try on clothes and try on holsters and look at different purses and different means of carry and talk to women who are involved in this and see the best way how they can more properly, you know, more easily, more comfortably get involved in concealed carry. And it has become wildly popular, and so much so that we have to cordon it off and set it off to the side to make sure that it is only a woman's only area so that we don't have, you know, Uncle Bob in there, you know what kind of gun you need, little lady. No, she gets to decide for herself.
Oh, Uncle
and gets,
Bob.
And gets to figure it all out. So all of those sorts of things will be coming up. And, of course, we'll be giving away the Charter Arms Professional Revolver. For those of you who may not have known that, Concealed Carry Magazine, myself, Bruce Wahlberg, our sales manager, and Ed Combs, our senior editor, we conspired or collaborated with? Let's say collaborated.
We'll go collaborated, yeah, less probable causey.
Yeah. And collaborated with folks over at Charter Arms to create an entirely new revolver, a 7-shot 32 H&R Magnum revolver. And I'm the first person in America who has shot this revolver, and we're giving it away to a lucky winner at the expo, and that person will get to be the second person in America to shoot the revolver. So that sort of stuff is going on as well.
That's pretty exciting. It's literally, really, truly is right on the cutting edge.
Yeah. It's the very first public announcement of this. We convinced Charter Arms not to launch this at the SHOT Show or at the NRA Show or anything like that.
Right.
They're doing it with us, for us, right at the Concealed Carry Expo, because quite frankly, we want the Concealed Carry Expo to be that place where new things in the concealed carry market happen and where people talk about it.
And it's obviously already turned into that kind of place if you have manufacturers that are launching products there.
Yeah, and getting bigger and better all the time. So it's we cannot complain about the way things are happening. So
yeah.
Did you happen to make it down to the NRA show?
I did not this year. Did you?
Yeah. Yes. Wandering through downtown Indianapolis, there was an NRA show there, I don't know, 5 or 6 years ago that I attended as well. And prior to that, I was stationed at Fort Benjamin Harrison, Indiana, while I served in the Navy and went to Navy journalism school there. So I hadn't really experienced downtown Indianapolis to the full extent. And
tell us about that experience.
Well, I looked out the
was
window
it moving?
Of my moving.
Okay,
that might be it. Looked out the window of my restaurant and saw a man defecating on the street in a pouring rainstorm. I don't know
Maybe so, you don't need a wipe.
He needed to clean himself up. I saw tens of protesters. They were really not well organized, and they were mad at everything in the world.
As
they walked down the street chanting their list of protests, it just kept getting longer and longer and longer. And it was everything from Donald Trump's immigration policy to abortion policy to everything else, and they just sort of milled around loosely, and lots of NRA members attending the show just sort of laughed at them.
It's always nice to have the petting zoo off on the side, for the kids.
One of the cool things I found at the NRA show, something I had overlooked at SHOT Show, more new handguns are coming out. More new concealed carry style handguns are coming out. And we met with the folks over at Stoger Firearms, and they're offering a new 9mm concealed carry size handgun, which we'll have in for testing here pretty
single
quickly.
Single stack, double stack?
Double stack, 9mm, but still quite small and comfortable. The interesting thing was it felt great. It had a wonderful trigger and will probably retail for less than $300. The MSRP is $319. So
they're going to sell a lot of guns.
Yeah, they'll keep things moving like that. But the NRA show, once again, a great place for people to get together and talk about guns and see what's going on, in the gun industry. NRA having a little bit of problems right now, some controversy in there, but
lots of internal issues.
Yeah, as long as they start talking about it and working it out,
right?
They are still the people out there supporting the Second Amendment,
right?
From a legal foundation, from a legal position. So we support them in the work they're doing. We just hope that they can smooth out their internal problems and get things going a little bit better. So,
right.
So, wow. Do we have a question? Max, what should I read for questions out here? So,
And by the way, good morning, Trina, Scott, Kevin, as well as everyone else that's watching.
There's another Kevin out there watching, huh?
Uh-oh, there's right. Two of you guys?
Yeah, well, no, there's another Kevin but
there's
M.
There should be a law.
There's know? Another Kevin M here at USCCA.
Oh, really?
And we get emails crossed every once in a while, so I'll be reading something that I have absolutely no idea.
But,
yeah, and it's like, oh, that's the other Kevin.
Other Kevin. Quick forward.
Send him down that direction. But so I did just write a internal USCCA policy on wasp spray.
Oh,
just,
really?
Yes.
Just the legend day. Lives on.
Yep, yeah, it just keeps going and going because someone in our social care team sent over a note like, hey, is this what we're actually supposed to say about wasp spray? So, yep, we formalized it. We put it on the document of official USCCA policies not to use wasp spray in a self-defense.
You know, was it Aristotle that asked something about, you know, who's the first mover? You know, I'm just saying, you know, and Aristotle said that was God. Yeah. I'm just throwing that out there as it relates to wasp spray.
Wow.
Some of you may get that. But
I'm feeling very inferior now in your presence.
God, all right.
And
Ten Hail Marys tonight.
There is bright light.
On it, Ten Hail Marys. Gotcha.
Shining, great. Shining all the way down. But
That's going to cost me.
So that policy is now in place, and we have an official statement that all of our member service advisors and our social care folks can put out with the
Max, please forward that to me, sir.
Yeah, of wasp spray. I should probably share you on the entire policy document, which just keeps growing and growing.
I'm sure I'm going to have to sign a bunch of things.
And I update it every week. Well, I do send them through legal channels to make sure that what I'm writing will actually hold up to legal.
No,
scrutiny.
Sign is in to make sure that I understand.
Oh, okay.
That's what I'm saying.
Make sure that these are the things that we're supposed
some
to
some inside USCCA humor here, folks.
So when are you getting to the expo? Are you?
I'm going to be there on Friday, and then I'm going to be on Saturday, and I think part of Sunday morning.
Okay.
But all day Saturday, that's going to be my big day.
Yeah.
I think I've got the live legal panel Q&A. I'm doing a presentation, a seminar. Last year, I think we just about packed the room for that. It was fantastic. The audience was involved. Looking forward to doing more of the same thing here. We got excellent feedback. We're looking to build and grow upon what we did last year. And then, of course, we got the Friday night LTB. So really looking forward to that. We're going to do the live training broadcast, kind of like a college game day style. Yeah. I think you're going to be part of that as well.
Yes, absolutely. And tickets are still available for that. That's a separate ticketed item to come in and watch the live training broadcast along with a live scenario, which will be played out right there on the stage. Actually, the scenario stage is a little off to the side. We will discuss previous proving ground and talk with the trainees who had been involved and talk about their actions and some of the stuff that they did. We'll do two of those. Then we will set up and run a live scenario right in front of everybody in the crowd and see how that plays out. And the trainee in that scenario is Jess, who is in our current member-only content. She's just starting her concealed carry journey. So this is, we're getting her from, 12 weeks ago, she had just picked up a gun for the first time.
That'd be perfect.
And now we're moving her all the way through scenario-based training to see how she responds in the scenario. And the instant that's done, we'll be back up on stage asking about, talking about what she did. And then afterwards, there's going to be some drinks and hors d'oeuvres and stuff like that going on. So a chance to meet and greet the people. So we'll be out there.
To talk to folks, answer questions, and get some live feedback.
And hear what people think about the proving ground and the scenarios. So what else do we need to talk about, Max?
Well, I think
pointing.
We've got to actually, I think, shut this down because we're actually going to be going live to members only. We're going to be taking actual questions that folks are submitting very soon, actually. So if you're members, there's a perfect chance to tune in. If you're not a member, if you liked our benign banter, maybe, but it'll be more focused.
I bet you could call now, sign up, get your membership, and be able to watch this member-only content. So what we're looking for and who will be helping out are the Platinum and Elite members. So if you just wanted to call right now and join up and become a Platinum or Elite member, I bet they could figure out how to get you the link to the member-only content. You know,
I have a suspicion.
Yeah, I'm really challenging both the member services folks and IT folks. They had no idea I was about to say that. Max's eyes are really big now.
Like, yeah.
You know, he's,
time to get that cappuccino going or whatever it is.
He's got a what the hell did you just say, Kevin, look on his face. But
it's kind of fun. You've got the power up here.
That's right.
Just remember, the cameras go off, we lose the power. But up here, it's, you know.
When the cams are still running, and I have told Max several different times, do you know who I am? You know, we start out with that a lot. Hey, do you know who I am?
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely.
So maybe I carry enough sway to get that stuff going.
We're
going to
find out. If there's no box appearing from about here down right now with the links,
So
I don't know. I don't know.
We'll just see. See how much power and sway I actually have.
But we actually do answer actual questions, so it's not just benign banter. Mm-hmm. So, you know, I think...
People want to know the legal implications using different types of ammo, factory-made ammo versus military surplus versus reloads and stuff like that.
So as a former state prosecutor and criminal defense attorney at the largest criminal defense law firm in the state, let me just kind of go through a couple quick things that I have seen from courts. So this is not hypotheticals. This is not speculation. This is live feedback from the trenches of our criminal justice system. Folks, I have been in court when judges have characterized any kind of hollow point, so expanding ammunition, as a so-called cop killer bullet. I have also been in court when judges have characterized non-expanding ammunition, full metal jacket, as military-grade ammunition, which no one needs. Well, I think that about wraps it up then, right?
Yeah. Yeah,
I mean, where are you supposed to do from that? Yeah. So, but this is the sort of thing that you run into. If you're hand loading, then I assure you that the prosecutor is going to make a big deal about the fact that you're manufacturing ammunition, and there's going to be a heavy implication, if not outright suggestion, that you're some sort of lunatic. And by the way, I reload as well. So,
And people need to understand that attorneys can say anything they want at any time in court. And then your attorney has to counter that argument.
There has to be enough pushback, and that's the key. Because when I've been in court, nobody has said this about one of my clients, because I know what's going on, I know what the score is. None of the prosecutors have ever made any of those suggestions about my people. But I've been sitting in court waiting for my case to be called when they're saying that about someone else's client.
Yeah.
You know what the defense attorney does? Nothing.
Yeah, he shrugs and doesn't know anything about
guns. They don't
know
the first thing about firearms. Yeah. And that's really going to be the key here, is at the end of the day, the prosecutors can say virtually whatever they want. As long as they're falling within the ethical framework of whatever state that you're in, they can say virtually whatever they want. A witness can get up and say whatever they want. You need to have the attorney who's knowledgeable about not only the law, not only the rules of evidence and all that other kind of stuff, but also, very importantly, firearms, to be able to push back, to be able to stand up for you when the chips are down. Otherwise, you're going to find out exactly what kind of attorney you have.
Yeah, absolutely. And, you know, if you're going to carry a gun, have a good attorney. And the USCCA can help you with that. So we're going to wrap it up now and get ready for the live member-only broadcast, which is going out to our Elite and Platinum members. And again, if you want to join up right now and become an Elite and Platinum member, you can probably get that stuff done in time to watch this member-only broadcast. We'll talk to you all later.
Coming soon. Bye, folks.